it's Baby Dragon. Welcome back to Suikoden, everyone. I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenrel. And today we'll be heading off into new territory, which is what this whole strategy of eating is about. As you can see, I did a little bit more gambling off screen and robbed gas for blind. I got another, 500,000 bits? And that took me like 2 minutes to do. Well, actually, it took about 10 minutes real time, but 2 minutes in game. Because he had a very unlucky streak in that particular time I played against him. But either way, I have near max bits. But we're going to be talking to Flick here. And we're going to get this strategy meeting started. And I'm going to be very, very quiet. Because there's going to be a song that plays here. And it is one of my absolute favorite songs in the entire game. Known as Theme of the Advancing Army. Go ahead, look it up. You're on YouTube after all. Open up another tab and listen to it or something like that. But, I'm going to be quiet and let you enjoy this. And I'm not going to even narrate this whole meeting just because of the music. Alright, and that is one full loop of the song. And doesn't it just want to make you get up and kick some ass? Yeah! I love how epic that song sounds, especially when you get to the middle of the song and near the end when all the trumpets and the brass instruments are going like crazy. Either way, we got a war battle again. Liberation Army, what's that? What, the guys who beat Kwanda's army? Just a generic captain or something like that. Nobody special here is in charge. Anyway, here we go, young master. Please take care. Let's go, Pine. So, I don't know if we'll get this option. Actually, I don't know if Pawn is even optional to begin with. Maybe they just make it sound like you have a choice to recruit him or not back when we defeated Craze. Either way, same as before. We're going to try and bribe them first and foremost, as well as see if we can check their tactics with our thieves. Now, Chandler, you have not been very helpful for me for a while, and it looks like you're still a failure. So, unfortunately, I still have not been able to show what that does when it actually succeeds. But either way, let's go spying and thieving and either get some bits or maybe learn what their next attack is. I don't know. But at least we outnumber them this time. So they're going to charge! Charge! So naturally, magic! Magic beats the charge, and we'll take no damage this time around. Windrune, show your power. And, well, I believe paper beats rock in this case. That was, half their army in one shot? Awesome. Alright, let's see if we can learn their new next attack or not. But, well, it's more than half, it's still going down. The next plan is charge attack. Oh, so I get an easy victory. I don't even really need to bother with anything else. Oh, magic. Use magic, me? Kerpow, we win. That was it. So I was lucky that my thieves were successful and actually told me their next attack. Either way, not a hard fight and doesn't take long to get back to in case you lose. But of course, you don't want to lose any Stars of Destiny in these war battles. Just kind of pointing that out once again. Because you can't actually have real deaths in this game. Typically, though, you won't have major storyline characters like Victor here die as a result of just a mistake in getting the wrong answer or something in a war battle. But other characters that are optional, they oftentimes do die or can die from a war battle. Either way, how's that? Ha ha ha! The Imperial Army XP, but they're nothing. Phew, oh young master, are you alright? Master Tyr, let's attack immediately and finish them off! Wait, Commander Tyr, we shouldn't attack without understanding what the enemy is thinking. I think Pawn has kind of got the adrenaline going after that, since we didn't really stand and fight much. We just used two magic attacks and blew them away. Anyway, let's send a reconnaissance team to find out what they're up to. You guys should probably listen to Matthew here. Either way. Oh, Flick too. Great. The enemy is careless right now. It's our chance to attack. Follow me, everybody. Alright, so right after that, we're going into another war battle. And unfortunately, this one's not going to go quite as well. But before we actually show that off, what our mistake is going to be here and why we shouldn't be attacking this castle here, I kind of want to go through all the units, just take a look at them, and just kind of show where everyone got placed. Anyways, what fools! I'll show you how wonderful my Antoinette is. Please be careful, there's something wrong. There is something wrong with this fight, as we'll see in just a moment. Anyways, let's go and look over the teams. So, Pont's still here. LePont's family. That reminds me, I'm still missing one person from that, and I'm going to have to go recruit him real quick. Jasper, why are you a part of the Invulnerable Defenses when you're one of the worst gamblers in the world and the single-handedly funding my entire army? Bandits, we know them. Fishermen, we know them. Humphrey's got his own team, but he's all alone in that unit. I had to go find the stars for him, I suppose. Good buddies. Gossiping lady, bathmaker, and innkeeper. I'm not entirely sure on that team, but they're oddly stronger than Victor's team. But then again, that's 3 versus 1. Old soldiers, old Kai is in there, and the kobolds. This is what I was talking about before, where Fusulu was lumped in the kobold group. Even though, if you look at his sprite, he clearly has man arms under that tiger hood of his. Formal Imperial team, naturally Valeria there. I wonder why Kwanda's not there, but then again, I think I know who else is going to be in that team when we get to that point later. Warriors Village Kids. That's kind of interesting, just kind of pointing out the name of Flick's team here for later. Kind of remember that later. Black Golds. Don't you mean Blacksmiths? Tricksters. We got Megan Jupo, of course. I forget who's the third one there, but oh well. Let's check out the bow users since we cycled around. Our elves are now in our best bow unit, thanks to, well... Naturally, bows are the trademark of elves in pretty much every fantasy setting ever. Soldier Beauties, they actually beat Cleo and Camille, but then again, I think if we get the third one in their group, they're probably going to be better than the elves. Why is Rock considered a cook? I don't know, he's a warehouse keeper either way. And I guess you could say map making is something of an engineering work, but probably not. I would say more cartography, or... Wait, is cartography map-making? I don't know. Either way, same magic units as before. Let's see if we can at least steal a few bits and some soldiers from Milish here before we suffer a humiliating defeat, because, well, you're not meant to win this... Oh, he failed. You're not meant to win this fight. It's scripted and all that, and... I at least want to try and put a dent in his army, even though it doesn't even matter. I just want to try and see if Chandler will be successful for once. No, can't bribe any of their troops, unfortunately. I should mention that you do want to try and use the merchants early, because however many you get from their unit depends on how many soldiers they have currently. Not their max, but like it'd be a percentage of like the 12,000 troops they have. So, we're going to send out a unit, which I know no one's going to die from, this poisonous pollen. What? 6,000 casualties due to a flower. Yeah, we should retreat. Game over, guys. I don't know why he says we're all over. I don't think that's proper grammar, but oh well. Enough of that, enough nitpicking. Let's try and figure out a way to get past those roses. Because we can't even get near the enemy. We're in trouble. Perhaps we should send a reconnaissance team after all. Okay, I'm coming along, dear. And Victor's coming with us, as well as Flick. And we now have the dynamic duo, as a lot of fans of the Suikoden universe would say. These two are two peas in a pod, I suppose. Anyways. Yeah, they're kind of... These two together are kind of like... Just good buddies and all that, but they kind of play well off each other with how the dialogue goes. Either way, you'll see very soon. Yeah, I'll go too. I haven't accepted you as commander yet. And I am going to acknowledge this line here in a moment once we get started on exploring the next region of the world, because I have a bone to pick with Flick here. I'll come along and see what kind of leader you are. So we'll get to that in just a moment. Young master, I'm going too, of course. Gremio, you stay. Victor, what are you saying, Victor? Who's going to protect the young master if I don't? Don't you understand, Gremio? Tyr is no longer a child. He's a proud leader of the Liberation Army. He's not a kid who needs your protection. But that's no reason why I shouldn't come along. I'll give you a reason why you shouldn't come along. You suck in battle. But either way, after leaving the village behind, I traveled all over the place. I met all kinds of people and experienced many things. That's why I sometimes have hunches. And why he wants Gremio to stay. You must be joking. Young master, you don't plan on leaving me behind, do you? Let's see if we can give him the boot. Stay here, Gremio. Young master, you two, such a bad joke. Stay here. I swear to Master Teo that I would protect you through thick and thin. Please, young master, take me with you. I swear my life to protect you. Stay here, Gremio. Please, young master, take... Okay, so he's going to nag us until we get... We actually say, come along, Gremio, you're bound to get in the way, give it up. And young master... And I think that it'll just keep repeating from there. So we had to say, alright, come with us. We have no choice, even though it tries to give us the illusion of choice. We have no choice here. Thank you, young master. To your kindness alone does not make you a leader. Anywho, Matthew's here if you want to add more members to your party. And I do want to bring along a couple people. Pawn is actually going to be coming in, have an important role very soon. And I want to start using him again, since the last time we used him was back in back when Ted was still around. But I also want LaPont. And you're probably saying, what are you crazy for short-range characters? Well, yes. Kind of, sort of, not really. There's a reason why I have LaPont in my party, and I already kind of hinted at that just a little bit ago. Pawn, go over there, in the very back of the group. Actually, I want Pawn right there, where LaPont was. Because there's a reason why I got LaPont in my party. There's actually someone we can recruit that is actually requires you to have LaPont in your party. Either way, if you leave the fortress and come back, you can recruit Kai if you missed him before. You're not actually supposed to come here until this point in the story, but there's also someone else here who we can talk to. Quincy. I am Quincy. Right now I'm just a hunter, but someday I'll make a name for myself. Can we recruit you? Join you? Let me see. Liberation Army or Imperial Army? It's hard to tell who's going to win. I'd like to be on the winning side. I'll think about joining you when you have a few more recruits. Say, 39 more. Alright, so I think we need like 80 recruits in order to recruit her, so I'm going to hold off on that for the time being. But for now, there's a little harbor town that we can go to called Tien. And I think... this is the town of Lac Virginite. I thought it was called Tien. South is village of Premier L'Amour. To the west is the township of Bière Blanche. Wonderful names were created for us by General Miller Schopenhauer himself, one of the five great imperial generals, and apparently a Frenchman, if just the wording is to be believed. Either way, so at this point in the game, it doesn't really give you any hints on where to go next. So right now we're just going to go around and do some recruiting and check shops and stuff so their inventory gets added to ours back at home. I'm not going to worry about buying anything right now, but we do want to recruit this gal here. Hello, my name is Hellion. You're Tyr, right? I know you. I myself wield the power over a rune. That soul eater of yours has unlimited in possibilities, but also evil intentions. I wonder what controls it. I'd like to look into your future, okay? Not for free, of course. I'll lend you my... Wow, that's kind of a good deal. I kind of get the better end of the bargain here. thanks. Let's go to your castle. Mine is the power of recall. So you want to recruit Hellion, not because of her as a party member, but what's in the chest right there. It's called the Blinking Mirror. And as she says, you can always return to your home base once you have it. So, like Vicky is there to teleport us away from base to go to whatever place we want to go to in the world. The Blinking Mirror allows us to return. And I really need to give Flick some equipment. I dump pretty much everyone's inventory into the vault off screen. And so now these guys have no equipment on them whatsoever. But I'm just going to show this for demonstration once we get onto the world map. And that's kind of why I brought LePont along. And now there's two houses here. We can't do anything with these just yet. But we want to remember this guy for later. You guys again, what do you want? I should probably have mentioned what he said. Let's see if I can leave and get him to say what he said the first time around. Okay, now what he said was he's an expert bulk maker and he's looking for someone to make use of his skills. Either way, I'm Aikai, a martial arts master. I have respect only for strong. Are you strong? No, you're only about 12 levels short, breaking the fourth wall and everything, but we're level 28, so when we're level 4, we need to come back to him and talk to him again. Recruit him, of course.
No visitors during experience, Yakumis out commendal.
Alright, so, those two houses and two people that are in there, well, we're going to make use of them later. For now, though, we got a blacksmith here. And if I'm not mistaken, once we've reached this part in the game, we can actually go above and beyond what we already had. Yep, we can now go... let's see how far our weapons can go now that we've got a better blacksmith than even what we have at home. Level 11... Level 12. Alright, so we can get our weapons up to level 12. Pawn. I want to make sure I get Pawn's Claws as high as they possibly can go. And while I do this, I'm going to make mention of a few things. First is what Flick said back on the bridge. Remember when he said, I haven't accepted you as a leader yet, and how... Back when we were, all the way back when we were in the Kobold Village, some survivors of the Liberation Army had come to aid us in defeating Quanda Rossman. Well, Flick, I believe, was even mentioned by Matthew back when we were there, and I believe Flick himself came to fight alongside us when we went to attack Quanda Rossman. I'm not entirely sure if Flick was there in person, but I believe... You know, the survivors of the Liberation Army that came to help us, I believe Flick was a part of all that. However, remember when we went back home? It was like 3 months have passed since the battle at Panayakuta Castle and all that. Well, back when we were on the Bridge of Garen, just at the beginning of this episode, Flick was like, I still haven't accepted you as a leader yet, even though it's been 3 months that he's been around us. Yeah, I think that's kind of a plot hole in the game's story and all that. But either way, getting everyone's weapons up to level 12. And wow. All right, Victor's got a new Quoten sword. Or upgraded it, either way. I'm going to keep going with my own staff. Obviously, it's the most important weapon in the game since it's the guy who's in our party all the time. And speaking of which... Since Tyr is in the party all the time, I highly, highly recommend that you give Tyr the Blinking Mirror, because it's possible to lose the Blinking Mirror, unlike in Suikoden 2, where it becomes a key item and you can use it from your key items slot there. But yeah, it is possible to permanently lose the blinking mirror if you put it, if you, especially if you give it to someone who might end up dying in a war battle or something like that. So yeah, just give it to Tyr, and if I'm not mistaken, yep, I believe you can actually discard it if you want to, even though it's a very important item and you cannot get another one of those. I don't want to actually use LePont too much, so I'm not going to sharpen his weapon all the way. But here's the beauty of having both the Blinking Mirror and Vicky. Yeah, you use a Blinking Mirror whenever you're on the world map, and you go straight back to base. This obviously makes recruiting a heck of a lot easier, and we're going to go off to seek it. I think I might have forgotten to get this guy for a while, but yeah, there is another recruit here back in the first town of the game. Well, not technically the first town in the game, the first town since we got out of the Gregminster area. But we talked to this guy here, and honestly, I did not realize this was a guy until I played Suikoden 2, because if you look at him, it kind of looks like Ellen, doesn't he? Either, sorry, I'm busy right now. Hey, why don't you come and play with me? Our family's rich, you know. And the Pachina. Uh-oh, Dad! I believe you told me you were going on a journey to learn about the world. Like I said, is chasing women learning about the world? You're coming with me. I'll beat some sense into you. Oh, okay, okay. I'll do as you say. Don't pull my ear. All right. So Sheena is obviously the kid of LePont there. Yeah, okay. So generic text. We don't need to worry about her anymore. Let's go home and... Well, this is the beauty of the Blinking Mirror. Once again, we can just go out and recruit someone and go right back home. All right. Now, I want to go get someone because now that LePont is... Well, now that we've made the last use of LePont that we ever will, I'm not going to even use him as a party member in the future. But we're going to go back home. We're going to put someone in our party. And obviously, it's going to be that person over there, Cleo. Since she is one of the best party members in the entire game. Let's see here. Sanchez. Oh, one more thing I should probably mention is something. Another thing that Suikoden did really well and fixed from this game is that you can. They gave the role of whoever gives you changes party members to someone who is less important to the story. So Matthew has been the one who's been able to change our party up until now, but now that we have Sanchez, we can actually change our party using Sanchez as well. Get off me, stupid sprite layering. But yeah, Matthew, as you might have expected, being the key strategist and all, oftentimes is busy with stuff in the meeting room and you can't change your party members when he's in the meeting room. However, Sanchez now has that role, so unless both of them are in the meeting room, like they were at the beginning of this, episode, unless both of them are in the meeting room, you can always change your party, either using Sanchez or Matthew. But in Suikoden 2, they fixed it by giving that role to a less important party member, or Star of Destiny, I should say, not a party member, because she runs the bar in Suikoden 2, and we don't have a bar here in Suikoden 1. But either way, I'm going to go back to where we were. Tien, not whatever that one guy called it, which honestly I don't feel like remembering the name of that French whatever. Peacock General, as they like to call him in this game. But yeah, go off to the left here, and like I said before, it's kind of ambiguous what you have to do to proceed with the story. And I'll show you what you have to do. I am assuming if you talk to people around the towns and all that, they might tell you. Oh, by the way, this is another Star Destiny we can't get right now. Welcome to, or what was it? Oh, yeah, Beer Blanche. A little town greeter of sorts, I suppose. But, yeah, you can see one reason why people in this region don't want militia control. They might actually favor us. It's because the guy who's in charge right now changed the name of all these towns and no one can ever pronounce them. But either way, we got another recruit here. Chapman, welcome. Pick and choose whatever you like, but if you don't have any money, forget it. Say, don't I know you? You're the tier leader of the Liberation Army. My name's Chapman. I may just be the owner of this sorry joint, but I still got a lot of heart. So please, let me join the Liberation Army. I can't stand being just a bystander anymore. Well, he's got something of a mouth on him, but he's our armorer, so we definitely want to get this guy. Speaking of which, speaking of armor, we should probably check to see what they have so they actually get added to his inventory back at base. Oh, wow. Oh, and by the way, toe shoes. A while back I said equip them on tier and don't take them off until I say so. Well, now I say so in about 2 minutes, because once you, if you have the toe shoes equipped, you can actually recruit this little dancing girl here. Unless, and I think if you don't, there'll be a hint saying you gotta change your footwear or something like that. Either way, you can probably tell in a minute that the designers of the game really liked Mina here, because they gave her like 20 different frames of animation and sprite art when we go and obviously dance with her, because that's the whole point of having the toe shoes equipped to recruit her. Is, yeah, in order to recruit Mina, we have to dance with her first. And just kind of watch both Tyr and Mina here, and just kind of see how bad Tyr is in comparison to Mina. What? Alright, well, only if you dance with me. Kind of strange that the designers went all out to give Mina that elaborate dancing animation just for that, but Tyr didn't have anything special for himself. But either way, yeah. She even appears on the loading screen whenever you start up a save file, so yeah. I think the developers at Konami had a thing for dancing girls with flowers in their hair. Just saying. Anyways, I guess you're trustworthy, because I can tell, because we all dance together. After all, I'm a pro. We'll work together, we'll work well together, Tyr. Alright, so now our castle has a dancing girl, and I don't think she actually dances when she gets back to the castle. But she does fight in battle, and she's actually pretty darn good, even though she's a short-range character and all that. But I do believe she has some pretty strong magic and some decent attack skills, or attack strength as well. Anyways, I want to point out this gal here, since we can't recruit her just yet, but she does mention an item name that we need to look for in order to recruit her. Oh, who is it? Have I met you before? Well, that's right. You're the leader of the Liberation Army. You're planning to kidnap me for ransom, aren't you? How frightening. Never said anything about kidnapping, lady, but I don't know. We'll go with it if that's what you really want. Well, I suppose that's my fate after all. It's because of my beauty, isn't it? Well, okay, I'll come with you, but not for free. You must show me your good faith. Let's see, I'll do as you say if you bring me the opal. So apparently she wants to be kidnapped for ransom, but we have to bring her an item in order to kidnap her. I don't really get it at all. Maybe it's a translation error. I probably don't know, but either way, there's one other person here I think we can get right now, maybe. Welcome to Jean's shop. Are you here on business? The Rune Sage here named Jean. Liberation Army? Could be fun. I'll join. So I think you need to have a certain number of recruits to get her, but apparently I had just enough. I actually did a recording of this earlier that I scrapped, but she wouldn't rejoin us. But now she will, so yay, I suppose we now have two new shops thanks to this one town. Alright, so I think we should head off to the next town, which is where we're supposed to go, and then go back to base. And there's one enemy, actually two enemies here on the world map that I should point out that you should pay attention to. And, well, if I actually get into a battle, that is. I just wanted to come to this location of the map just to get it on my list of places I can teleport to. We can't actually go into Soignier just yet, but we do want to go full circle back to the east to the town that's there on their map. And this guy here. Whenever you see Holly Fairies like this, kill him. Because they drop an item that you need to get a recruit that is actually another shopkeeper for headquarters. And if I don't get it here on this episode, I will say, you know, I will do it off screen if I have the time to do it. But I'm planning to go out of town fairly soon, so I might not. I don't really have a whole lot of free time right now. Except for, well, I'm recording an episode here, but either way, enough of that. I'm just kind of trying to plan my time for the rest of the week. So either way, let's just kill those guys. No, we did not get it. That guy in back. I just want to point out that little lid plant thing in back. And those things are dangerous. They're called a creeper, but those are dangerous. And I'm going to try and run if I possibly can. Okay, good. He didn't use his attack. That is really dangerous. And the reason I'm taking a lot of damage right now is because those guys don't have any armor on them. But, oh, good critical hits and all that. But, yeah, that little lid plant thing, those things are really, 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 really dangerous. And I'm going to try and run here. I didn't mean to actually free will. But that is the attack you want to avoid. Hits three times for massive damage, and it can usually kill someone in one attack. So, yeah. You kind of want to not fight them or avoid them as much as possible. And thankfully, we have a town right here, and we can sleep at the inn and all that. So, let's check out the item shop, get his inventory back in our castle. And, oh, by the way, I should probably mention a thing about this paint and these seeds. You don't really need them right now, but the seeds are going to be needed for recruiting someone else later. And it just makes it easier if you get them in Chapman's inventory back at the headquarters. So, yeah, check every item shop you see, and there you go. You'll be able to recruit whoever that is once we get that far in the game. Excuse me, won't you help me look for my cat, Mina? We kind of recruited a dancer named Mina, but not a cat, unfortunately. If you find her, I'll join your entourage. Alright, so, we need to keep our eyes out for cat. Actually, we know where that cat is, but we'll get to that later. For now, though, we're going to check this little appraiser shop. And my name's Jabba. I'm an expert appraiser. If you find something I can't appraise, I'll do anything you ask. And that thing he can't appraise is actually dropped by those holly fairies on the world map. And it's called a nameless urn, just in case I don't get one this episode. Keep an eye out and try and get that to drop if you're playing along. So yeah, that is what you're going to need to recruit Jabba there. But anyways, in order to proceed with the story, you need to get on the boat that's docked there in Recon and go this way. I think if you talk to people in town, they might point you out to where you have to go next, but it's kind of ambiguous. The game doesn't really give you any hints. They just say, go on a reconnaissance mission. But in order to get rid of those roses that are on Milish's castle, you need a special alchemist of some sort, or a doctor, or something like that, that can get rid of those poisonous flowers, or at least the poison itself, and so we can actually fight Milish properly. Either way, what you have to do is come all the way down here and check the rapids. When you see that text box pop up that says rapids, just either go back to recon or use a blinking mirror. We're just going to leave this boat out here in the ocean, never to, well, dock again. And we're going to have the conversation here, which we would have on the docks of Recon if we went back that way. What shall we do? We can't go back any farther. This is impossible with an ordinary boat. Alright, so in order to get a good boat that will go across the rapids there and get to that little hut that's over there and just beyond those rapids, you have to go back to Tien and talk to that one expert boat maker that's kind of hanging around here. Because, well, he's looking for something that's worthy of his skill, and now we have something that's worthy of his skill. You guys again, what do you want? We need a boat that can beat the rapids. The Rapids of Dunnan, eh? I thought the Republic of Dunnan was to the north. But oh well, interesting. Alright, I again will show you what I can do, but I can't do this alone. Or is it Jin? I'm not entirely sure how you pronounce it. I've got other games with characters named Gen, like Saga Frontier. I've never actually figured out how to pronounce it. But either way, an ordinary boat will never make it. Then what will you do? I have some ideas. Old Commando next door should be able to help us. Even if he's half dead, let's go see him. Alright, so we gotta kick out everyone else besides... We're gonna have to have a full party of required party members, but only for just a little while, so we're gonna have to kick out everyone else. Anyway, look at the sign here. This old geezer thinks he's a big shot. Hey, old man, I know you're in there. Come out, you bum, or I'll break down the door. You again. I taught you not to disturb my experiments. Here you are, you creepy old man. You should get some sunlight. You look sick. Come on out. I warned you not to call me old man. What do you want with me anyway, bringing these delinquents with you? The delinquents? Don't you dare insult young master. I can't understand such language for Victor, though. whoa, wait a minute there. Don't confuse the issue. Hey, geezer, you know the Dunning Rapids? I was going to ask you how they can be navigated, but come to think of it, a senile old fool like you wouldn't have a clue, right? Watch your mouth. I can do anything to bang on time and money. So he's got a bit of an ego, too. Anyway, so there is a way. Of course, I'll show you. Step inside. Alright, so right smack dab in the middle of this guy's living room is a giant freaking steam engine. Yeah, not much for home decor, are you, Commandal? Alright, look at this. This will get you over the rapids. What is it? I just told you, it's a steam engine. It's a machine, an oil-burning engine. A machine that runs on oil? Sounds ridiculous. Kind of get the idea what kind of times these guys are living in. So if you attach this to a boat, you can travel upstream? Correct. Okay, then, let's take this to Plummy Lamar Promy Lam Pramyam Lobby. Premiela Amour, you idiot. Kind of contrasting sentence there. He starts with something French and he's like, "You idiot! Shut up, who can remember what stupid name like that?" Let's go to recon. And we're doing some recon, by the way. Anyway, take care of this machine. It's fragile. What? You mean we have to carry it? Of course. You plan on letting a frail man carry this? Now, here's something I find funny. In this very city, you recruit the one gal whose name I forget already that gave us the blinking mirror. Before that, we had to run into Vicky in the forest on her way to the kobold village early in the story. So what do we do? Blinking mirror. Oh, tears over here, by the way. We teleport over to where we need to be. Since we've already been to recon once before, we can just use a blinking mirror. Oh, by the way, Hellion, now I remember her name. And then just teleport back to where we need to be. To recon. And you have this conversation. We took like 10 steps to get out of the city. And then another 50 steps to get right here. And they say these things. Here we are. Good, go ahead and load the equipment. And thank God I can bend this load for Will. Apparently very heavy. It's pretty tough fighting with this on my back. What fighting? We didn't do any fighting. We teleported here. Hey, geezer, let's get to work. So they complain about how heavy this was, even though we essentially teleported all the way here. Anyways, Tyr, you're getting in the way. Why don't you go to the inn or something? Don't worry, you'll have a shiny vessel in no time. Alright, so they're going to go back and work on that. Anyways, damn that old man making me carry such a heavy load. You're exhausted from teleporting here. I guess in context, if we actually walked all this way, it might actually be a relevant conversation. But anyways, let's call it an early night and have a conversation of some sort. I don't know, maybe something like that. Victor is sleeping. Flick is sleeping. Gremio is not sleeping. He might actually be contemplating Victor's words a minute ago. And here's another thing I wanted to talk about, which I haven't had enough time to talk about. Is Gremio here? Or is it pronounced Gremio? I'm not entirely sure. I've never really known how to pronounce his name. But either way, I've always said Gremio in the past. But either way, I, Gremio, have taken care of you since you were tiny. Sometimes I feel as if you were my little brother. No, my son, even. Initially, I wanted to repay my debt to Master Teal, but now, perhaps you no longer need me to protect you. So he's actually taking Victor's words into consideration when he's like, Gremio, you stay here. Let me tear you up. How are Gen and his crew doing? Let's go check on them, shall we? And we'll worry about Lottie later. One thing I should point out is whenever you're here in Recon, absolutely, positively make sure to look for a guy in a black cloak that might appear here. I don't think he appears until you have 100 Stars of Destiny, but in the off chance, or the rare chance, that he actually appears here in the inn, make sure you talk to him. He's a guy named Clive, and he's one of the 108 Stars of Destiny, and like I said, I don't think he starts appearing until you have 100 characters at the very least. I usually do not ever see him until I have all 107, and he's usually the very last one I end up recruiting, simply because it's a bit random when he shows up, but I think if you have all 107, he will just show up there being the last Star of Destiny. Either way, take a look. We worked all through the night. Making an old man like work like this, for shame. Aren't you like one of those nerd scientists who doesn't know the concept of sleep? But either way, Tyr, how about a launching ceremony? Alright. Got any wine to smash on the side of the boat? Anyways, let's go on board the boat. And let me talk about Gremio for a second here. What he was talking about there while we were sleeping in the inn, he was saying, I, Gremio, have protected you since you were a baby. Want to repay Master Teo and all that for what he did for me? Something that's not really talked about in this game story, and I think there was a publication in Japan only, but there apparently what happened long before the events of this game, probably during the War Succession where Barbarossa became the Emperor, I believe Teo was on the battlefield and he saved Gremio's life, and essentially Gremio had no way to repay him, so essentially he became a servant of Teo and had the responsibility to raise Tyr here from a baby while his father was always out and doing missions for the Emperor. So that's kind of how he came to be a servant of Master Teo. Either way, we're raiding this old man's house for some black paint. Yeah! But anyway. Okay, so yeah, the game doesn't really tell you that to go out and look for this guy named Dr. Liuken. I don't know. Dr. Liuken? But you have to find this guy so he can make you a potion so you can survive those flowers on the castle. Game doesn't really tell you anything about this, but I am. This is where you have to go deal with it. You'll probably find this out on your own if you talk to the NPCs in the city, but I didn't. Either way, so it appears I tried to isolate myself to no avail. What do you mean? You want me to prepare some medicine, right? I'm tired of all that. So this guy apparently was some legendary doctor that had a very good track record of saving people's lives and all that, but then he got tired of it and decided to become a hermit. And now we need his help to get rid of some flowers on the castle. I don't really get the plot here, but either way, please, sir, we must have an antidote for the poisonous flowers of Milish's castle. That kind of antidote would be very inconvenient. Who's that? Who is it? It is a dragon. And Peacock Man is... a lot of people like to call him. How do you do? I'm the most renowned of the fighting great Imperial Generals. Milish Oppenheimer, the Flower General. Nonsense. The greatest of the five is General Teo. Naturally, that's Gremio who's going on about that. this must be Teo's lowly servant. And this here is Teo McDowell. Your father must be in tears to know his son is a traitor to the Empire. Hey, you, Peacock Man, what's your business here? Oh yes, I nearly forgot. It just won't do to have you render my sweet flowers poison useless. I shall invite Dr. Luikin over to my impenetrable Sonia prison.
Like hell you will!
Oh, please don't be shy. We must be going now. Tyr, I'm not a sissy like Wanda, you know. Well then, goodbye, everyone. Funny, that's kind of the word I'd use to describe you exactly as sissy. Also fruity and veggie head and all that, since he is the flower general. But either way, how humiliating having him snatched away in front of our eyes. So all that just to get a guy we've never met before or even heard about before gets snatched away, and now we're just kind of that humiliated. Oh well, Saudi Air Prison, that's one tough place to break into. We'd better ask Matthew for advice. For the time being, let's return to Torn Castle. Alright, so that's it. That's all we gotta do here. Now, there are some, there is some fighting you can do here on the world map, but I don't think any of these fights are actually worthwhile. So, let's just blinking mirror back to base. And before we go off to talk to Matthew, I am going to go look for that cat, since it's only a little bit out of the way. We gotta go to, I believe it's Kaku. It's the, we really could just take a boat here. But, you know, this is that cat that, you might have been wondering what this cat was doing here all this time. And, well, this is Lottie's cat. So now we kind of already know what to do here. Let's go back and, even though I'm too lazy to take the boat, let's go back and go recruit Lottie. Not going to take us very long after all. Oh, good. Here she is. I looked all over for you, Mina. Thank you, Tyr. My name is Lottie, Lottie the Magician. I, as a guest gesture of thanks, I'd like to join you. And yes, she is a fairly strong magician. She's the same type of character as, say, Luke or Hellion. They have staff, they don't do much damage in their short-range characters, but they have extremely high magic stats. And she is one of those characters. So, let's see here. Thinking mirror, back to base, and now let's go talk to Matthew and see if he knows anything about getting into Sunny Air Prison. Alright, so I came to the third floor, and look at this. Looks like some remodeling's been done. We must have reached new castle level. Oh, me disappeared again. Okay, so as usual, that cat runs away all the time. Probably wants to be a stray and all that. But either way, now that we've got a new castle level, I probably should go back out to the boat and give you a good look on the outside. We now have a much bigger fourth floor as well as some new areas to explore, so we might as well do that. For now though, we'll do that in a little bit. I just want to continue with the story just a little bit farther, and then we'll end off the episode after doing a bit of a tour of Castle Level 3! I see, Dr. Liu can understand, I have an idea, please wait a moment. In the township of Entai, which I believe is now called Beer Blanche, lives a counterfeiter named Kimberly. Let's get her and a scrivener named Tesla to join us. Kimberly is an acquaintance of mine. I've written her a letter. Give her this letter to her and she'll join our cause. What do you plan on making them do? Let's save that pleasure for later. For the moment, please go find Kimberly and Tesla. Interesting choice of words, Matthew. And I kind of already know what kind of a gal this Kimberly is. But if you kind of haven't guessed what I'm hinting at right now, you can probably find out in about 1 minute when we get to Entai. And I love being able to teleport around, if you couldn't tell, because it just makes recruiting and getting through the story a lot so much easier, so much better. But either way, so here is Kimberly behind the inn, and so let's give her the letter. What is it? A letter from Matthew? Let me see. Oops, I forgot to mention that I can't read. Why didn't you say that in the first place? What's it say? Okay, I'll read it. I see, Matthew's up to his old tricks again. Old tricks. You'll be joining us then. I think we know Matthew's dirty little secret. Hey, you there. Mommy? Yes, you're a handsome fellow. I'll join up if you promise to take me to dinner. Sure that's all not all you want to me? I can't. I have someone deceased. Either way, alright, do what you want with him. Victor, you! Good, it's a deal. Come here, pretty boy. Whoa, wait a minute. Glomp. Come on, fill my cup, handsome. Yes, ma'am. And Flick is not enjoying this one bit. All right, don't spill any. Okay. It's your turn next. Your cup's still full. Come on, drink up, or do you... You can't you drink tea with a beautiful woman? Sure that's tea or not sake? I'm not entirely sure, but... Oh, no, not at all. And Flick is obviously not ready to get into a relationship because he still wants to remain loyal to Odessa and all that. Good grief. Well, I'm off to go ahead to Torn Castle or whatever. How can he stay out all night and look so well? He must be a mess right now. Either way, what are you talking about? You're still tired, pretty boy. Say, Tyr, are you planning to recruit Tesla too, right? He's here in this town. But I believe he's using the name of Albert. Albert, is it? Okay. Interesting information to know. Well, I'm going now, pretty boy. We'll have dinner again when you return to the castle. No thanks. I think we know Matthew's dirty little secret after all that. Either way. Let's go check out on... Albert! Who are you people? I'm just a normal, quite ordinary citizen of this town, obviously avoiding us. You're Tesla the Shrivener, right? Goodness, no, my name is Albert Onyx. My people have lived here for generations. Really? Then what's your mother's name? Her name is Marianne Onyx. Shouldn't you be able to just fire that off right away rather than think about it? And your father? I believe it was Alan Onyx. Good way to know your parents. Grandmother! Leah Onyx. Hey, Tesla. Yes? That's not my name, Tesla. Do you give up? Alright, Matthew wants me. I prefer to leave a quiet life. Stop yapping and get ready to leave. Whoa, Victor, taking charge. Now it's his turn to get his way. Okay, my God, how lucky I am. Led back into a life of crime. Interesting choice of words since we're breaking into a prison and all that. By the way, do you think it's okay to let him go by himself? What else is there to do? He doesn't want to travel with us. Shucks, treating people as if they were bandits. It's because you scared him so much, Victor. Dynamic duo, indeed. A lot of people like these two because of the conversations they have with each other. Young master, we should be going back to Torn Castle too. Alright, let's go. And I don't think there's anything else left to do in this region of the world. So yeah, we should go. And that black paint is bothering me. I really should go back to the Rock's place and pull some equipment out of the vault and put some stuff like that black paint in, because I really should mention that black paint we got back at Dr. Lewican's reclusive little hideout there is a one-of-a-kind item, and you definitely want to make sure to stash it in your vault. I did not mean to go to the third floor. I really should just go back. Actually, what I really should do is go outside and check the castle from, you know, see the outside of the castle now that it's level 3. Anyway, let's deposit that black paint. And I'll deal with him more later. I'm just going to dump a few key items in here. And then we'll go back to Matthew. Not going to spend a whole lot of time here, but let's go. Alright, and this is probably the last of the story that I'm going to have for this episode, and the rest of it is just going to be just exploring our new level 3 castle. And but don't blame me if it doesn't work. I created this imitation seal myself. I guarantee its safety. We're probably supposed to talk to Matthew first before all this, but Commander Tyr, you're back. We made all the necessary preparation. Kimberly Adesla did excellent work for us. I'm a perfectionist. I too did well, I hope. What? Excellent work. Commander Tyr, what you see here are forged Imperial papers. Milish's signature, the official Imperial seal, it's all there, perfectly forged. So basically we got fake release orders and all that. These papers, we can walk right into Sony Air Prison. Please free Dr. Lyukin with these. And fake orders, which are a key item, unlike our blinking mirror. But either way, well, now that we're done here, I worry about Liuken. Please hurry. Now that we're done here, anyways, I think that's the last of the story we'll be going over today, and next time we'll be exploring Sunnier Prison. For now, though, we're going to take a look at our castle from the outside, now that it's level 3, and see where everyone else has, well, disappeared to, I should say. And I'm probably going to make sure to change my party members around before the next episode. I'm definitely going to make sure to put Pond back in my party, and probably Cleo, I think. I'm not entirely sure. I'm thinking either Cleo or Camille. I don't think we have any boss fights, so be a good time to level up someone I like. Nothing new in the basement except Hellion. We never did talk to you before. What could this old woman do for you? Nothing, at least. At least not for right now. Do you just make sure that blinking mirror is in proper working order at all times? So, more shops. Chapman is here, and he should have everything we've seen in the armor shops up until now. And look at that inventory. Woohoo! And we're probably going to be doing some shopping as well as farming up that nameless urn so we can get Jabba's shop here, which is going to be our appraiser. Jane's here, so we don't have to go to Sika anytime we want to change our runes. And I believe, if I'm not mistaken, there's a new wing of the castle up this way. And it's just a little area here and a little hovel here. And it looks like Barkus and Sidonia claim this place for their own. But now you're a soldier, is not bandits. You work for me. All right, let's see what's over this way. I think, by the way, I can give the boot to Genin Commandal now that we've done the whole thing with the ship engine and all that back in recon. But either way, we've talked to you before. I don't need to talk to you again. So I believe all the Imperial generals are going to start hanging out in this wing of the castle. But other than that, let's go back to the east. We did recruit Sheena, so he should be in the eastern wing. Let's see here. Oh, there's Camille, by the way. Yeah, I do like Camille. She's one of my favorites, and I probably am going to start using her a little bit more when we have more free space in our party, not taken up by required party members and all that. I mean, there's some fine women in the Liberation Army, aren't there, Tyr? Cleo's... Don't you go hitting on Cleo. She's my type of girl. Also, she's going to be fighting all the time, so you won't be around to chat with her too much. going upstairs. And things have shifted around. Now that we're at Castle Level 3, Rock's got his vault over here. And I think for the most part, this is going to be the final layout of the castle. I think there's going to be one minor change when we get to the final level of the castle, which is Castle Level 4. But for now, though, this is pretty much how things are going to be for the rest of the game. Do you want to see me dance again? Wouldn't mind it, but don't have time. Alright, let's take our bath and see what kind of new bath they had. Last time it was a wooden bath, now it's something of a concrete bath. So yeah, the bath does upgrade every time you get a new cast level, and there's going to be one left later on. No one new here. So let's just keep going up and up and up and up and up. Oh, that's not up and up and up, that's down and down and down. Alright, let's go one more time, and we'll take a closer look at third floor and the fourth floor. I like to go home. I have to clean my house. Okay, he sounds like he's being held hostage here. Never mind that. Let's just keep going up and up and up and up and up. That room's kind of bare right now because we got more recruits that are going to fill that out a bit. But yeah, this is going to be our headquarters now. And my nose is getting all stuffy because it's getting cold out, and then my nose tends to do that at this time of year. By the way, there's actually a fifth floor, and we're going to go see that in a sec. Doesn't look like my room's changed at all, but they did expand the fourth floor. It was just about this wide here, and these rooms didn't exist before, and even Matthew's room didn't look down there. It was just before the fourth floor was about this big, and that was it. Just this little hallway here and all that. Anyways, one more floor to go up to and take a look. So we got a rooftop. We're at the very top of the castle now, and I don't think anything's I think later on we'll get like a laundry room or something up there, but for now though, we're going to go back down to the first floor and save our game. And off screen, I'll try and get that nameless urn from the Clay Elves. And rearrange my inventories and all that. And what else? Try and get some armor from Chapman here. And maybe change some runes around. I'm not entirely sure. I'm going to try and make sure everyone in my current party is going to have the best armor. So like this headgear. This ninja suit, which also provides a speed bonus, which is real nice. By the way, now that we've got Mina, you can unequip the toe shoes from tier, even though I don't have anything that's better and all that. But thankfully, we can still buy feathers. same defensive power as the toe shoes, and I think it's one of the best accessories. Nope, actually, we got better now that we've been to new areas. So yeah, I can give the... I think the guard ring is the best one that we have at this point in time in the game. But, yeah. We are probably going to do some re-equipping. Gasper is going to be lending me some money for that. And, yeah, I'll just prepare for the battles ahead. Like I said, the next dungeon that we're going to go through, I don't think has a boss fight in it. So, don't really have to worry about any tough fights, at least. But it's a pretty long dungeon regardless, so definitely make sure you're a bit leveled up and all that. And it's a good place to level up Pond because, like I said before, he's going to play a major role in the story coming up pretty soon. So now's a good time to level him up, make sure his claws have been sharpened very well, and level him up in Sunny Air. Aside from that, I think everything's covered for now, and we'll be... doing a jailbreak next time. So, look forward to that, and thanks for watching. See you guys next time.